श्री गणेशाय नमः ॐ श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवम् परमानंदमाधवम् We will read from verses from verse number 16 till verse number 19 together.
त्रैवं सति कर्तारं आत्मानं केवलं तु यः पश्यत्यकृतबुद्धित्वा न सपश्यति दुर्मतिः यस्य नाहं कृतो भावो बुद्धिर्यस्य न लिप्यते हत्वापि स इमान् लोकान्
नहन्ति न निबध्यते
ज्ञानं
ज्ञेयं परिज्ञाता
त्रिविधा कर्म चोदना
करणं कर्म कर्तेति
त्रिविध कर्म संग्रहः ज्ञानं कर्म च कर्ता च त्रिधैव गुणभेदतः प्रोच्यते गुणसंख्याने यथावत् श्रुतान्यपि
द पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर डूअर्स द पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर डूअर्स एंड दीज पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर डूअर्स Doers, the kartas. In any action, they are fivefold. Panchaitani mahabaho, karanani nibodhame. Am I audible to everybody? Yes. So the five functionaries or the doers, I'm using two words, functionaries or the doers. In any action, good or bad, nyayam va viparitam va, what are the five? Adhishtanam, which is body, karta, which is the doer thought, the ahankara, the one who wants the action and feels that he is the coordinator of the action, the one who has the thought which has identified with the body, etc. It is an identification thought. Ahankara. And this identification thought is called karta. Why? Because once it identifies with the body, senses, etc., when they do an action, perform an action, because it has identified with them, it feels it is a doer. It's an identifying thought. It's an I thought. It's an I thought we all have. Now, as you are listening, what is the I thought? I am listening. As I'm speaking, what is the I thought? I am speaking. As you are sitting, what is the I thought? I am sitting. This is the I thought. So, first, adhishtanam, body. Second, karta, the ego. This is also a participant in the action, a functionary, a doer. Body is a doer, karta also is a doer. Karta also is a doer because it feels that it is doing. It identifies. And without that identification, doing is not possible. Without that identification, without I arising, how will you do anything? First, you have to be there. Then only it functions. So, the five functionaries are adhishtanam, body, the ego, the ownership thought, the ego, the identifying thought, karta, karanam, the instruments of action and knowledge, including their coordinator, the mind. So, antarindriya, bahirindriya. Then, vividhascha pṛthakcheṣṭā. The various pranas. And ultimately, the blessing factor, the cosmic blessing factors which bless and enable daivam. These are the five functionaries in action. So, these are the five functionaries of an action. Okay? All right? So, what is it you want to say? These are the five functionaries of an action. Whether it is good or bad, these are the only functionaries in an action. These are the only functionaries, only doers. Doer 1, doer 2, doer 3, doer 4, doer 5. Karta 1, karta 2, karta 3, karta 4, karta 5. Is it not? Body, karta 1. Then the karta, the ego, karta 2. Then the 3. What is the 3? Karanam, karta 3. And what is karta 4? Prana, the cheshta. That is karta 4. And what is karta 5? Karta 5, the cosmic deities, blessing. These are the five kartas. And what is the consciousness doing? The consciousness is not a karta. It is a akarta. What is the consciousness? What is your real nature? Now my false nature is adhishtanam, karta, karana, cheshta, daiva. I have taken myself to be this conglomerate. Conglomerate, this combination, this sanghata. I have taken this to be me. Right? These which I have taken to be me, that these are the functionaries. These are the karta 1, karta 2, karta 3, karta 4, karta 5. And I, in my true nature, am the pure consciousness. But not for me, these five kartas cannot function. But for me. But I don't function. In my presence, they all function. In my sannidhya, they work. In my mere presence, they work. I supply them the life. I supply them the sentiency. Be it the body, be it the senses, be all the five. Karta one is karta. Because of me, the akarta. Karta two is karta. Because of me being the akarta. Karta three is karta. Because of me being the akarta. I am akarta. I do nothing. In my presence, everything functions. Who are you? I am that consciousness. Are you the body? No. Are you the karta? No. Are you the karana? No. Are you the cheshta? No. Are you the daivam? No. Who are you? You are the life of the adhishtanam. You are the life of the karta. You are the life of the karana. You are the life of the cheshta. You are the life of the daivam. You are the very life principle which enables everything. Lady asked Gurudev, Gurudev, by your grace and blessings we have come to spiritual life. But our husbands, they do the same nonsense. They go to these cocktail parties. Nothing happens there, Swamiji, just gossip. Should we also go or not? Husbands are telling, come. Should we go or not? You know what is cocktail party, no? Should we go or not? Gurudev said, you better go, otherwise somebody will take your husband away. Then he told very seriously, look, you go. But there, when they are talking nonsense, when they are gossiping, when they are having what they want to have, you, what you do? When their lips are moving, non-stop, you ask the question, what is that because of which these lips are moving? And take your attention to that principle of life. Right? That principle of life, in truth, I am. In its presence, everything happens, but it does nothing. In the presence of magnets, iron filings move, but magnet does not move. In the presence of sun, the whole world wakes up, except for a few. The whole world wakes up in the presence of sun, but sun does not come until you get up. In its presence, it happens. I am the life principle, the consciousness. In my presence, the body functions. But I am not functioning. In my presence it happens. I am the very existence, the very consciousness which bestows life. I am the very life giver. I am the very energizer. Right? Karta 1, Karta 2, Karta 3, Karta 4, Karta 5. But I am Akarta. I am Kevala. Kevala have no variations in me. I am of the same nature. There is no loss of energy, there is no gain of energy. I am the infinite resource of pure consciousness. I am Kevala, undifferentiated, pure consciousness, existence, bliss. The functionaries being Karta 1, Karta 2, Karta 3, Karta 4, Karta 5, the one who does not understand his nature, but considers Kevalam Atmanam to be Karta. Kevalam Atmanam to be Karta. Which verse are we? Verse number 16. Tatraivam sati kartaram atmanam kevalam tu yaha pashyati akrta buddhitva. Why does he see the self to be the karta 1, karta 2, karta 3, karta 4, karta 5, even though he is a karta and kevala atma? Why? Akrta buddhitva. Simple thing. He has not been educated. Adhyatma vidya has not been given. That's all. It is a question of knowledge. If somebody does not know cos square theta plus sine square theta is equal to 1, it is a question of he didn't study mathematics. Nothing seriously wrong with him. He didn't study, that's all. Like most of us. We forgot. We didn't study. If you study, you know. This is also a shastra, a subject which is logical. Right? Pashyati akrita buddhitvat. And truly, such a kind of wrong comprehension of oneself, nasa pashyati. We should not tell that person is seeing. Because wrong seeing is seeing. Nasa pashyati. Why? Durmatihi. The mati, the mind, is still tainted with ignorance. But then, yasya naham krito bhavaha. Verse number 17. Buddhir yasya na lipyate. Yasya naham krito bhavaha. Bhavaha, his understanding, his comprehension. His comprehension is how? His comprehension, in his comprehension, there is no identification. Na aham krito bhavaha. Yasya bhavaha, his comprehension, is not tainted with aham kritaha. Is not tainted with aham kritaha, is not tainted with tadatmya. Is not tainted with tadatmya, is not tainted with identification. His comprehension is free of identification. Jnani. Because he has been educated. He was blessed in his life by a presence of the Guru. He was blessed by Shravana. He blessed himself by Shravana. He worked himself with the assistance of the Guru and got the doubts clarified. Manana. And later on, he meditated upon that knowledge to conquer the unconscious fetters which are lying deeply hidden. Deeply hidden. Intellectually clear, but still living a life of an individual. Why? Unconsciously the thoughts are there. Like how one may cut the grass, but if the roots are there, it will keep sprouting again and again. In the same way, one was gone deeper and removed those roots also by the practice of meditation. And later on, one who has abided in that knowledge and is firmly established, not losing for a fraction of a moment the clarity, I am that pure kevala akarta atma. Such a person is untainted by identification. Today we are untainted by knowledge. Whatever happens, I am individual. Correct? Our mother has worked, our fathers have worked so hard to give that feeling to us. Of course, we have it inherently because of ignorance. But even the other things. Suppose your name is Suresh. How much effort our parents put to get that I am Suresh in our head. You remember? You will not remember, but you can see others what they are doing. Baby, baby. The baby does not have a name. What is your name? Baby's name is Suresh. Suresh. Who is Suresh? The baby does not know. The mummy takes the hand, puts there, ensures that this finger is pointing. Suresh, Suresh, Suresh. Daddy, what is baby's name? Daddy says, Suresh. Is it not? And then the baby is taken to the mirror. And then, where is baby's nose? And the baby points to the nose. Not first. Mother point. Ear, head. And then, this is baby. Poor thing. Infinite, pure, innocent consciousness. That pure, unfettered spirit. We locked it in that body and then named the body, and pura life that fellow goes about Suresh, Suresh, Suresh. And then later on they teach him in the school, I am not A Suresh, but I am B Suresh. And in Kerala, if you go, you are not B Suresh, you are Suresh B. Kitna nonsense. Is it not? Like how I am Suresh B is so deep and not a moment is forgotten. So deep, even if he is sleeping, somebody calls Suresh. Not somebody called Suresh. In the TV, some Suresh name was called. He gets up. Is it not? In the same way, what in the same way, so deep rooted that Suresh is there now. In the same way, if we call consciousness, nobody raises the hand. Sat, Chit, Suresh. Yasya naham kruto bhavah. One whose understanding is not tainted by Suresh bhava, but clarity of himself being consciousness is there. And Suresh is only a namesake. Like a drama, we take a name and we function. Isn't it? In a drama, they act. One person becomes Antonio, another person becomes Bassanio, another becomes Portia, another person becomes Shylock. They all act the drama. The quality of mercy descends from heaven like rain. But afterwards, he behaves properly. He doesn't behave like Bassanio or Antonio or Shylock. Isn't it? These are Shakespeare characters. for those who wonder what it is. Okay? Why? That is only a drama character. The same way Suresh is a drama character. But in truth, I am consciousness. One who has this awareness. He's not identified with the Karta 1, Karta 2, Karta 3, Karta 4, Karta 5. But knows himself to be the Akarta Kevala Atma. Such a person, whatever the Karta 1, Karta 2, Karta 3, Karta 4, Karta 5 does, he is unattached. Because he has not done. He is not doing. Good or bad? Such jnanis do good only. But Hatvapi Sayiman, even if he kills, meaning let it be any action. That is the point. Good or bad, immaterial. Nahanti, he is not the doer. He does not kill. Why he is not the doer? He is not killing. Because he is not Karta 1, Karta 2, Karta 3, Karta 4, Karta 5. He is a Karta Atma. How many of you are taking notes? How many of you are writing? No, you are all wrong. Karta 1, Karta 2, Karta 3, Karta 4, Karta 5 is taking notes. Suresh will not go so easily. In Hindi, there's a word, Guzgaya. No, one word is there, Guzgaya. Abhinivesha. Okay. This is, you actually practice Vedanta. Theek hai? Such a person, Nahanti. And because you do not take notes, the understanding also is not yours. Nanipadyate. The result of it also is not for you. Shall I tell you some interesting story? Very enigmatic story. The first time I heard it, I was so fascinated. I heard from Gurudev only, I think. Durvasa Rishi is on the other side of the Yamuna, other bank of the Yamuna. The gopis are all here. And Krishna, Bhagavan Krishna also, Gopi Krishna, all of them are here. Durvasa Rishi is there and they want to offer bhiksha to Durvasa Rishi. They have to carry food and go through the Yamuna. But the Yamuna, it is rainy season and it is in spate. No boatman is willing to come. So the gopis do not know what to do, how to go there. So they approach Bhagavan Krishna. Whatever shlokas they want to chant, they chant. And then they say, Bhagavan, Krishna, how to go there? The Yamuna is in spate. We cannot cross. Sri Krishna does not have any hesitation. He tells, go and tell Yamuna, if I am not a grahastha, married how many? 16,008. Some of them who are asking are also his. If it is true that I am a Nitya Brahmachari, go and tell Yamuna to give way. Married man, how can he be Brahmachari? Unmarried, that is the meaning. So they also go. Krishna said, oh Yamuna, if it is true that Krishna is a Nitya Brahmachari, give way. Yamuna gave way and they went. They gave to Durvasa Rishi, Bhiksha and all those things, and he ate and then he belched also. So many of them giving so much food, then natural only. What can he do? Not his fault. Full. No time to go to rest. Now again Yamunaya gave way, but then now they go there and they find Yamuna is still in, it's in spate. Now what to do? Now Krishna is not here. So they go to Durvasa and say that, how to come, how to go now back? How did you come? How did you come? Then they told that we went and asked Krishna. And what did Krishna tell you? Krishna told if he's Nitya Brahmachari, Yamuna should give way. Oh, acha. You go and tell Yamuna, if Durvasa Rishi has not even eaten a single morsel of food, give way. In front of their eyes only, they only gave the food, he only ate, he belched also. And now this fellow is telling, this guy is telling, if we are not in a single morsel of food, eh, kya? They went, Yamuna, if it is true that Durvasa did not have even a single morsel of food, give way. Yamuna gave way. But this time they did not go. They went back to Durvasa. What is this happening? Yasya naham krato bhava buddhir yasya na lipyate hatva pisa iman lokan na hanti na nibadyate. One who has not identified with karta 1, karta 2, karta 3, karta 4, karta 5, but knows his real nature as pure consciousness, he is neither a doer, grasta, nor a enjoyer. He did not eat food also. Because who ate food? Karta 1, karta 2, karta 3, karta 4, karta 5, who did the action? Became bhokta 1, bhokta 2, bhokta 3, bhokta 4, bhokta 5. Karta only becomes bhokta. How many of you are taking notes? The one who is taking notes will understand. You are pure consciousness. The one who does not take notes will not understand. But you are pure consciousness. Notes has nothing to do with me. Not taking notes has nothing to do with me. Understanding has nothing to do with me. Not understanding has nothing to do with me. Provided you understand this. All right. Yasya naham krito bhavah. Beautiful verse. Important verse. Mark it. Yasya naham krito bhavah buddhir yasya na lipyate hatva api sa iman lokan nahanti nanibadyate. This is the tattva of the highest sannyasa. It is for attaining this sannyasa too is there, shravana manana nididhyasana, and he attains this knowledge. And the sannyasa 3 is abiding in this knowledge and reaping the full jivan mukti ananda because of abiding in this knowledge. In sannyasa 2, you get the knowledge. You got the knowledge. In sannyasa 3, you reap the blessings, full blessings of the knowledge. And one remains ever immersed in the infinite bliss, which is called jivan mukti ananda. Okay. In this way, the tattva of the second and the third also Bhagavan Sri Krishna finishes. Topic over. And then, in order to explain how atmanam kevalam, how the self is kevala. Kevala, non-differentiated, pure. Non-differentiated in terms of prakriti. Non-differentiated in terms of prakriti, prakriti is sattva, rajas, and tamas. The self is not differentiated into sattva, rajas, and tamas. In order to show that the self is non-differentiated, Bhagavan Sri Krishna shows how everything else is differentiated. All differentiation is in the realm of prakriti and not in the purusha. All sattva, rajas, tamas variety is in the level of the matter and its functions, not in the level of the spirit. Not in the level, not in the realm of the consciousness, which I am. In order to explain this, kevalam atmanam begins the next series of descriptions of everything being threefold, 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 threefold. That is not to say it is exhaustive. It is only to give a sample which you can apply elsewhere. Who can exhaust the realm of matter? Infinite. It cannot be exhausted. But yet, putting them all together, in terms we can comprehend, which are directly comprehended by us, Bhagavan says, jnanam can be threefold. Karma can be threefold. Karta can be threefold. Meaning, they are not kevala. Threefold when you say variety has come. Variety when it has come, it is not kevala. It is not kevala. Whereas atmanam is kevalam. So to give clarity about the nature of the self, the not self is described in three categories. To give clarity about the nature of the self. But there is also a hidden agenda. What is a hidden agenda and for whom is a hidden agenda? There is a hidden agenda to help the category one sannyasi. And who is a category one sannyasi? The karma yogi. How does it help? By showing jnana to be threefold, the first category person is said, drop the rajasic. Drop the tamasic, hook your mind to the sattvic. That is a hidden agenda to assist, to help. Even though the topic directly pertains to how the self is kevala, it assistance is given also to the karma yogi. Karma is threefold, sattvic, rajasic, tamasic. O karma yogi, give up the rajasic, give up the tamasic. Go to sattva. Karta is threefold. Give up the tamasic, give up the rajasic, be a sattvic karta. Right? And then, karana is taken up in terms of buddhi and dhriti, the instruments that we use. Karma, jnanam, the knowledge of the objects. Jnanam. We have the knowledge of the objects. Karma, the action that we perform to get the objects. Karta, the very doer who goes behind. Jnanam, karma cha, karta cha. And then one karanam is there. Karanam karma karteti, trivida karma, sangraha. You remember that karanam is there. That karanam is later on taken up in terms of, karana is instrument. And that instrument is our own buddhi. That buddhi is divided into threefold. And to achieve something, we need dhriti. Dhriti is a perseverance. That perseverance is divided into threefold. You see? Jnanam, jnayam, parijnata. Right? And then, karanam, karma, karteti. Jnanam, if you put like this, okay? Jnanam, jnayam, parijnata. On top you put. Jnanam, jnayam, parijnata. On top. Then bottom you put karanam, karma, karta. Two sets of threes. On top, what should you put? Jnanam, jnyeyam, parijnata. Okay? Jnanam, jnyeyam, parijnata. On top. Bottom, what do you put? You put karanam, karma, karta. Okay? Two sets you are putting. Should I say again? On top, what you should put? Jnanam. Then, jnyeyam. Then, parijnata. Bottom, what you should put? Karanam. Then, karma. Then, karta. Two. And now, these six, Bhagavan says, I will tell you three. And what are the three? Jnanam. Now, what you do, the next one, under that, you put three. Top one, three. Then bottom, three. And then still more down, you put three. What are the three? Jnanam, karma, karta. So these top six, Bhagavan reduces it into three. By combining the six in some way or the other and reducing them into three, and these three, which is representative of the six. What are the six? Jnanam, jnyeyam, parijnata, karma, karana, karma, karanam, karma, karta. Six. These six he reduces into three. Jnanam, karma, karta. Now, how does he reduce these six into three? If you would like to understand, understand. If you like to ignore, you can ignore. Freedom is yours. Everything need not be understood. You see, some of them are chaltaya. Even chaltaya, I am telling you. Others think don't should live like that. But if you want to understand, the knower is the doer. Parijnata is the karta. Okay? So you put a straight line, connect them. Parijnata is the karta. Jnyeyam, what action you should perform? Jnyeyam, how to perform an action? How to perform? That is jnyeyam. How to perform an action later on becomes an action. Is it not? How to perform, which is jnyeyam, that becomes what? Karma. So jnyeyam and karma you put together. Okay? Jnyeyam and karma. So what is left now? Jnanam is there. And what is left? Karanam is there. That jnanam, keep it separate. So jnanam, separate. Okay? Jnyeyam, you have merged into karma. Parijnata, you have merged into karta. So what all is there? Jnanam, karanam, karta, karma, and karta. Four are there. Out of the four, he says, now I will tell you three. What are the three he says? Jnanam, karma, karta. But watch very carefully. I will tell you the three also. Dekha also hai? Did you see? Verse number 19. Jnanam, karma cha karta cha tridhaiva guna bhedataha prochyate guna sankhyani yatavat shrunu. I shall explain. Tani, these also. What is also here? Api is also. What is also? You are telling me api. If I ask what is api, you will tell also. But what is the also here? Karanam. Because that he has reserved for future. Reserve for future means what? After he finishes the three, he will take up the karana. And what is a karana? Karana is our buddhi. We use our intelligence to function, is it not? It is our own mind. It is our buddhi. And that he will say threefold. And additionally, he will tell you, buddhi is there, but all people using their buddhi do not achieve. There are many people with buddhi. But what is lacking is dhriti. Perseverance. That perseverance also is threefold. In this way, first of the six he reduces to four. The four, in the four, first he finishes three and then leaves one for later, and that one he divides into two and deals it with detail. Swamiji, too many things, Swamiji, too many points. Humko nahi chahiye. You only remember one thing. I am not taking notes. I am not understanding. I am neither the one who takes notes nor the one who understands. I am the pure consciousness. Swamiji, what? You are telling us to be lazy? No, I am telling you to focus on the essence. But then why did you tell this? Because there will be people who want to know. Therefore, I told this. Please excuse me. Okay. All right. So, informing us, now he is going to tell the threefold. Threefold what? Threefold jnanam, threefold karma, threefold karta. Also, first he starts with jnanam being threefold. Jnanam being threefold, the objects. Objects, the knowledge of objects. Knowledge of objects, the vision of the objects. The vision of the objects, the vision of the world itself. Because what is the object? Object is part of the world. The world is nothing but objects and beings. And therefore, our knowledge or vision of the world of objects that we see is now described to be threefold. Knowledge. Knowledge of object. Knowledge of object, the vision of the object. The vision of the object, the vision of the world of objects. The vision of the world of objects, the vision of the world of objects and beings. In other words, the vision of the entire realm of objects. Comprehensive. A vast canopy. Object, you can take one object. That is not the point. The object is part of the world of objects, you see. And the world of objects is the world of objects and beings. So the vision or the knowledge of the world of objects, he divides it into threefold. Why? To say Atman is not threefold. This in Vedanta, we use the term atattvārthavadalpaṃ. That's the term we use for that. Vyavritti, negate. By showing world is threefold, negate the threefoldness in the self. By showing threefoldness is there only in the world. What are you achieving? The consciousness which is a substratum of the world. The consciousness which is a substratum of the self is free of this variety. What is this technique called as? Atattvārthavadalpaṃ. Write down. Vyavritti, negate. atattvārthavadalpaṃ, negate what it is not. Negate the world, show the world to be threefold, and thus negate the self to be pure homogeneous. By showing the world to be threefold, what are you negating? You are negating that the self has none of these differences. Okay? Shall we see now? Swamiji, introduction is fine. Now you move forward. You want to finish the text or no? Don't you worry. That is sufficient. I want to tell you the last session on the last day, which is given as Kṛtsnavadēkasminkāryē session, will be converted to an actual session. Because every day I am meeting all of you and answering the questions, and Brahmachari Anand is, you are not giving him rest at all, asking all the questions. He is very happy that you are asking questions. So last day, which is 9th morning, 7 to 8, in the schedule is written as Kṛtsnavadēkasminkāryē session. I don't think that will be Kṛtsnavadēkasminkāryē session also, because I don't think the need is there. If it is there, we will see. I will ask the earlier day. Okay, now we move forward. Verse number 20.
Sarvabhūtēṣu yēnaikaṃ.
Sarvabhūtēṣu yēnaikaṃ.
Bhāvamavyayamīkṣatē.
Bhāvamavyayamīkṣatē.
Avibhaktaṃ vibhaktēṣu.
Avibhaktaṃ vibhaktēṣu.
Tajjñānaṃ viddhi sāttvikam.
Tajjñānaṃ viddhi sāttvikam. Pṛthaktvēna tu yajjñānaṃ. Three verses, sattva, rajasam, tamas.
Pṛthaktvēna tu yajjñānaṃ.
Pṛthaktvēna tu yajjñānaṃ.
Nānābhāvānpṛthagvidhān. Vētti sarvēṣu bhūtēṣu.
Vētti sarvēṣu bhūtēṣu.
Tajjñānaṃ viddhi rājasam.
Tajjñānaṃ viddhi rājasam.
Yattu kṛtsnavadēkasmin.
Yattu kṛtsnavadēkasmin.
Kāryē saktamahaitukam.
Kāryē saktamahaitukam. Tattāmasamudāhṛtam.
Atattvārthavadalpaṃ.
Atattvārthavadalpaṃ.
Tattāmasamudāhṛtam.
Tattāmasamudāhṛtam. Sarvabhūtēṣu yēnaikaṃ. Bhāvamavyayamīkṣatē.
Avibhaktaṃ vibhaktēṣu.
Tajjñānaṃ viddhi sāttvikam. Pṛthaktvēna tu yajjñānaṃ. Nānābhāvānpṛthagvidhān. Vētti sarvēṣu bhūtēṣu. Tajjñānaṃ viddhi rājasam. Yattu kṛtsnavadēkasmin. Kāryē saktamahaitukam. Atattvārthavadalpaṃ ca.
Tattāmasamudāhṛtam.
We will start this in the next session. Okay? Then we will go at one go and finish all the three. Which all the three? We will finish karma. We will finish jnanam, karma, karta. 9 verses we should go at one stretch without a break. 9 verses? 3 for each. Without a break, we should go. Okay? So our next session will be 9 verses at one go. Why we have to see at one go? Then only you will get one comprehensive view. We'll take up in the evening 4 o'clock session. So what 4 o'clock you should do? Whatever you want to chant, meaning prapartaya, whatever, should be all done before. So sharp at 4, we should start the Om. namada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vashishyate om shanti shanti shantihi harihi om shri gurubhyo namaha harihi om.